Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Ecky-Man, and welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Okay, so who are we gonna play today? Let's do an Eve run. Really putting off doing the blue baby stuff. There's a seed in case you want to play along. So Eve starts with reduced damage. It's not too bad, but to make up for it, we do have this, which is the Horror of Babylon effect, which becomes active at one red heart as opposed to half a heart like every other character. That's going to give us a damage and a speed up. Prayer card, reusable eternity. Okay, well, I'm going to use that now. So that's going to give me a health up. Well, it gives me an eternal heart that will give me a health up if I make it to the next floor with it without taking damage, which hopefully we will do. I should have saved it until I had done the floor, but oh well. Okay, so we get Pin. Easy enough boss. Did we have a tinted rock on this floor? I think we did, so I'll double back and get the soul heart. And we get a health up, which is okay, I guess. Of course, it does knock us out of Horror of Babylon mode, unfortunately. Okay, so let's move on. Hopefully we can find a blood donation machine so I can get back down to a single red heart. And reactivate Horror of Babylon, because otherwise our damage, I'm not going to say it sucks, but it's not great. Alright, well, I'm just going to do this. Okay, well, I want to grab that trinket, that's the petrified poop. That's going to give us more chance of drops from shooting poops. Okay, let's see what the item room has for us. And we get Bob's Curse, 5 poison bombs. Not great, not bad. Okay, oh yes, we also start with the dead bird, so when we take damage, dead bird will pop out, do some damage to enemies. I'm going to blow these up, get a bunch of money, so that's good. Starting the floor with 5 cents gives us a chance of an arcade, and if we get an arcade, then that should have a blood donation machine in it, and I can use that to trade my red hearts away for money and reactivate Horror of Babylon. Ideal thing to find in the devil room would be Guppy's Paw, so I can just trade my health away for soul hearts straight away and maintain Horror of Babylon. We do need to take this run to the dark room. I'm gonna check the shop. BFF. Well, I want that, so we're going to blow these up. I also want that soul heart, so I'm going to blow this up again. And again, apparently. Thank you very much. More trinket space would be super useful too. Do you know what? I'm actually just going to get some money back from this. We do need to donate, well, if we donate a bunch of money to this, it will unlock more stuff in the shop, more items for sale, etc. So I'm really just sort of setting myself back a bit here, but I feel like it's worth it for more trinket room, so we're gonna take that. Need to be careful of these grey spiders because they do blow up. And of course these red fires will shoot at us, so they're not too good either. I'm gonna save my bombs. Let's go fight the boss and we get the horns, which is gonna be a real drag. Okay, well, there goes half a soul heart. Don't take any more. Oh, well, okay. So now I can't take any more damage, otherwise I'm not going to get a deal with the devil. Thankfully, we have the dead bird out, so that's going to do some damage for me. I'm going to drop a bomb off right there, which will do a bit of poison damage. I'm going to drop another one. That was close. Old bandage, HP up, awesome. Okay, and we're gonna get ourselves the dead cat, 9 lives. And that will of course reactivate. Come on now, it's gonna reactivate. Tower of Babylon. So we can now go here. Well, we can't actually go there, so no problem. Well, we have no keys, so that's why I can't do it. So we're now 1/3 of the way to being Guppy. I'm going to go drop 2 coins back into the donation machine. Actually, we should probably just put all 7 in. No, I'm going to buy that, put 2 coins in. There we go. Give it some money back at least. I don't want to get the health up from this prayer card, because that would cancel out Horror of Babylon, which I don't want to do. So now we're really hoping on a soul heart. So I need to keep a good eye out for a tinted rock, and there it is. Hopefully we get a freebie, because I have no bombs. Shoot at me, shoot at me. Okay. I'm just gonna let this guy shoot that for me, thank you very much. Grab that. Paralysis. Well, it could have been worse. Alright, so now we have some protection against taking damage, and hopefully we should still earn a deal with the devil. Item rooms down there, that's good. Come on. These enemies are kind of annoying. Okay. That was a stupid move. I'm gonna get ourselves Flatworm, which increases the hitbox size of our tiers. Infamy gives us a chance of blocking damage from any direction. Well, this room kind of sucks. Don't rush me. Don't rush me. Okay. Let's check down this way then. Come on. Look down. Kind of sucks, but no problem. And we get the husk. Should still be on for a devil room, hopefully, if we're lucky. We're not guaranteed it, but we've taken no red heart damage, so We should be able to earn it, if it's possible to earn it on this floor anyway. No, 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 no. Yeah, we got it. Mom's coin purse. Mom's coin purse. Okay, will I be able to take both of these? No, I won't. That sucks. What if I die in here? Will I respawn in here? Let's test it out. Oh well, okay, never mind. If I'd have only... Oh, it was health. It was health down all the time. If only I had taken that pill before I went in there, I could have grabbed both of those. Guaranteed myself devil rooms after every floor with goat head. I'm interested in the curse room, but we can't go there yet. So ideally what I should have done there is gone back through into the boss room, then killed myself there, and I would have respawned inside the devil room. So I sort of did that to myself there really. I could have gamed it and made it work, but I messed up. But anyway, we have Guppy's Paw now, so we can change, we can do that. We can swap a red heart for two soul hearts, or three soul hearts, however many I got there, and that now puts us two-thirds of the way to being Guppy. And being Guppy would really help us out because we are going to the dark room, so the increased damage would be super nice. Okay, we might get some free mushroom explosions here, and we do. Okay. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Bad gas, okay. The fool transports us back to the spawn room. Alright, moving on. So we're going to keep Horror Babylon active all the time, obviously, because we have no red hearts. It's pretty good. There's the boss. Still want to find the item room first, though. And it wants... Well, that's from the Liberty Cap. Oh yeah, I forgot we have slots for two trinkets. Item room's all the way back there, so let's head back. Go pick that up. Yeah, we'll stick with the trinkets we have. I'm interested. I shouldn't have been. And we get ourselves number one. Short range, but what am I trying to say here? Short range, but fast tier rate. Wait, what happened here? Oh, have we got Curse of the Maze? Is that what's gone on here? And I just haven't realized it. Alright, so we need some range up. Curse of the Maze? Yeah, I do. Okay. Alright, well, I'm gonna blow these three up. Magic Mushroom, please. Okay. It's a shame. Nothing good. And we get the hollow. Easy enough boss. Hopefully we get another devil room and we can get another guppy item. That would be sweet. No, okay, it's fine. Still need some range. Okay, let's check this room. Yeah, well, I'm interested. Marginally worth it. Could have just let one of those grab me and that would have thrown me out of the room. Save me fighting this third wave. Increased chance of pill drops. Yep, I'll do that. Oh, I just walked straight into that. Just realized I'd backed myself into a corner in time there so I could get out. Hat's no good to me. Mask and hat room sucks. Okay, moving on. Oh, my range is so terrible. Well, hopefully we can get something that will make up for that, because that's going to make the dark room tough. So number one is an item I would sometimes skip, because of the small range it ends up giving you. But I couldn't remember if I'd already picked it up or not on this save, so there it is. At least would I have to get it again. Although knowing me, I will forget that I've had it and pick it up again at some point. Wow, we are moving fast. Okay, we get a HP up, speed down, we feel stompy, so we can now stomp rocks, which we are going to... Why did I do that? Wasn't paying enough attention, that's why I did it. Okay, hoping I can get a ladder down to the crawl space or the black market. Not gonna get one though. Was worth checking. Better take that fly out before, well, before it did that. Okay, we can actually influence our range by doing this. Oh, are you kidding me? I can't actually hit it. I have no bombs to clear this room out with either. Oh, this is ridiculous. There we go. That's why short range sucks, people. We have a tinted rock in here, no bombs to get it with that. Oh, Mask of Infamy with short range. This is gonna hurt. This is really gonna hurt. At least I have the speed to get away from it. Alright, gonna have to do the trick of shooting it from the side. Like so. Well, I think my Mask of Infamy there just blocked damage from the mask. Pretty cool, shot speed and damage up. Alright. Well, I will take Rotten Baby, I guess. We have BFFs, so it's probably worth doing that. Moving on. And let me just grab a drink here. Okay, depths 2, 19 minutes. Never gonna make boss rush room. So that's out of my hands. It's kind of what I was hanging on to the fool for, though. Health up, sure thing, I'll take it. Transfer it straight over into soul hearts. I'll go to the curse room. And hope we get something good. I found pills. It's not good. Could have used the full card to get out of there easier. Well, that was good. We just knocked the dingles back into the spikes there. Saved me actually fighting them. I'm going to check the shop. Immediately wish I hadn't. Oh well, we've got a tinted rock here, so that's really not too bad. Thank you, Mask of Infamy, for saving me there from damage. Bunch of money. Oh. Maggie's Faith. I will take that. So that's going to give us a Eternal Heart at the start of every floor. And soon as we have all soul hearts, we would have to die to lose the Eternal Heart. So I can take that quite safely and then turn the health up into soul hearts at the start of every floor. And things will be great. Haven't found the doodads yet. What am I trying to say here? Item room. Keep forgetting I have this ability. Let's go this way. Thank you, Mask of Infamy, for saving me there. Okay. Almost got enough money to go to the shop, so I probably will do. That little dingle just charged straight into a blue fire and killed himself. Awesome. Not the right way. Yep, just sort of did that to myself there. Pop you. Get a Sin Heart, was totally worth it. Let's go this way. See if we're gonna be able to avoid. Whoa, I just. Oh yeah, I can stamp on rocks anyway, so I could have got out of there. No problem. Okay, found the item room. Soy milk? No, thank you. High Priestess. Wheel of Fortune. I'm gonna take... I'm gonna take the Fool. Never know if we might need a teleport. Alright, so let's go fight the boss. Depths 2, so we're fighting Mom. Wait, I haven't found... Oh yeah, we found the shop. There was nothing in it, was there? Well, there was, but it wasn't something I want. It was greed, of course. Okay, hoping for a devil room here. Let's just cheese this. Damage is not very good. Alright, well, we have to take that. Do you know, I had a feeling it was going to be this guy. Trolling me. I knew I wanted a devil room. So he shows up instead. Well, at least we got Lump Call, so that increases the damage of our tears the further away they get from us, but they're not going that far away from us at all, so... Half useful, half not. So we still have one more... devil room available to us. One more devil room we can earn, but we're not guaranteed it. Magus Faith gave us the Eternal Heart as we started the floor here. So, we'll get a health up on the next floor, turn that into Soul Hearts. Okay, let's go this way. And we get Pride. The moon, random teleport. I'll take that. Oh no, wouldn't this teleport us to the secret room? I think it does. Let's find out. Yep. Money's no good to me, unfortunately. We don't have a shop available to us anymore. So where did I leave that card? Down here. Okay. Grab my card and move on. Well, I'll check the challenge room. See what we have available to us. Yeah, okay, I'll do this. Kind of hoping for a devil room teleport, but alas, it's not what we got. Did get ourselves another soul heart though, and a health up, which I can instantly turn into more soul hearts, so I'm fine with that. Rotten Baby of course spawns kamikaze flies, and because we have BFFs, it does more damage than normal. I could just teleport out of here. Could have avoided fighting that entire room. But no problem. Okay, so we're going this way then. No, I don't really want pushpin. I'll pick it up just so I've had it. Gives us a chance of piercing shots. Okay, I get that. No problem. Okay. mask just saved me from some damage there. Mom's Pearl emanates purity. I believe that increases chance of finding soul hearts. Come on, pop up. You know you wanna. Ah, oh, they take so long, these ones. Come on. Thank you. And we found our boss. And it would be these guys. Little trolls. Oh. Okay. Take your time. Don't worry about us. Thank you. Left hand. Greater chance of red chests. Not gonna bother with that. And we get Mr. Fred. A joke of a boss. Honestly, he's pretty terrible. Although with this short range, actually. Yeah. With this short range, he is quite good. Especially seeing as he keeps making those blood trails, which makes it hard for us to actually get in there and attack him. So all those times I've laughed at this boss, he's just basically trolling me back now. No devil room, that kind of sucks. Tears and shot speed up. Range is terrible. Alright, we're going to get health up here. Use it instantly. Let's have a look in here, do a bit of bank gambling. Paralysis, not interested. Yeah, let's just go. I'm gonna blow these up actually. Alright, let's do this. And let's try left. Nope, left's not right. Left is definitely not right. Never has true words been said. Okay, up we go then. Alright, Loki, calm down. Nope, nothing good. Wow, this room kind of sucks. Found an item, we got placenta, regeneration and health up. It's pretty sweet. Paralysis, not interested. I'll take the fool. Yeah, not interested in doing this fight either. What's that do? Hematemesis. Sorry, what was this one? Range up! Yay! Yeah, not bad. Alright, well, I'm gonna fight this. Why not? I was just gonna use the fool to pull out of here, but we can do this. Although, yeah, optimal play, should have just used the fool to get out of here. Missed him with the bomb, it's a shame. Okay. I'm gonna pop all these rocks. Again, looking for the black market or the crawl space. Thank you, mask. Alright, must be right then. Well, hopefully it's right. Yeah, that's why those ones are just not worth popping. They're like the mushrooms. Okay, doing it with bombs, but you don't really want to walk into them. Too much chance you can hurt yourself. Although, as you saw, we did get an item dropped from one of them, so they are pretty good. Rainbow poop gives us full heal, but not now because obviously we're using soul hearts. Justice, okay, I'll use that. Why do I do that? Why do I do that every time? Well, we found the boss. Okay. Shielded tears would have been really nice to get with this item, number one. High fire rate would have meant we could quite safely block tears and still land hits. Alright, just follow the lasers. Okay, so we're going to Shoal. Let's do this. Again, we'll get a health up on this floor, which I can turn into two soul hearts, like so. Why did I place a bomb down when I could have just stomped my way through the rocks? Oh well. Still gonna work out for us. It's not gonna be left, it's going to be the quad room, I betcha. Well, that magnet's kind of helping us out here. It's drawing all their tears towards the center of the room, which is nice for me. Don't need the heart. So it doesn't look like we're going to get to be Guppy, unfortunately. No cricket's head. Magician gives us homing tears for a room. Missed with a bomb again. Get ourselves a free secret room. Okay, quad monstro. I will take the magician. Keys. Okay, let's go through here then. Nope. Is the head just gonna sit there? That's kind of weird. Huh. Not that I'm complaining, that's fine for me. You don't want to attack me, that's fine. When we get strength, I guess I can take this. Actually, the smart thing to do here, a bit of use strength card. and then use Guppy's power to convert it to some soul hearts. Get some free soul hearts like that. Paper, don't want that. Stick with Maggie's faith. Joker, please be a joker. Two of spades, doubles my keys. High priestess, I'm gonna keep the magician, I guess. Yeah, this room. Wow, Mask just saved me from a lot of damage there. Okay, moving on. And here's our boss. I'm gonna use the magician in here. Get some homing shots going. Alright, Satan, calm down. Alright, phase 2 done. Now we just got the feet. Thought I'd moved enough there. And again, thought I'd moved enough. Okay, on we go. Health is looking a bit poor now, though. Well, we have Curse of the Unknown, so I don't even know what my health is now, unfortunately. Health up. Use that instantly. Speed up. I'm down for that. Okay, and we get Guppy's tail. Is that going to turn us Guppy? It is. We got Guppy right at the last second. Awesome. Can't ask for better luck than that. So Guppy's tail is now going to give us more chance of chest drops. So hopefully more items, which means more power. We also now spawn kamikaze flies that do 2x our damage. And we get flight as well, so it's pretty powerful. It's extremely useful for us to have here. As you can see, the flies are doing really nice damage. Book of Sin, reusable item generator. Might be better for us to take than Guppy's Paw. We have no health to convert, so I'm going to take this. As you saw, we just got ourselves a Sin Heart. So in the long run, might be better off to have this. Now I just hope we don't get any stupid rooms like a double adversary or a double cage. And we'll be okay. Scapula, if we get down to half a heart, we will get a soul heart, which used to only work with red hearts. I believe now we get the same thing with soul hearts, so that's pretty good. Mr. Mega improves the blast damage of my bombs. Yeah, this is a room I didn't want. And that's why I didn't want it. Oh well, we found the boss. So as long as you do semicircles around this guy, chances are you can avoid taking damage. And we get Bloody Lust. Means it might be worth taking a little bit of damage here. Wish I knew what my health was. So Bloody Lust gives us a damage up every time we take damage, up to 6 damage up. We can get hit 6 times. Kamikaze, not interested. Kind of interested to know if I can actually get any more items out of this. That's why I'm still going. Bad trip. Definitely not interested. Alright, I should stop trying to push my luck here. Because there's always a chance we'll get a double cage room and just get killed. So let's clear the boss. We might do a full clear after we're done with this. But as soon as I need to clear the dark room with Eve, it's probably best if I don't take any chances here. Okay. That's you dead. And that's you down as well. Okay, well I'm not going to risk it. We're just going to finish up. And we have now unlocked the black lipstick. So, that just leaves us with the blue baby. Everyone else is done. Okay, well, I guess I'm going to call this the end of the episode here then, guys. As always, I really hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more of The Binding of Isaac. Peace.